Hi everyone, so welcome back to this channel once again, and in this session I'll discuss OUTQ in AS400. So start with the introduction of an output queue. An output queue is basically an object of type star OUTQ. Let me show you. So once I do work object for object type star OUTQ, you'll see mostly the OUTQ is created in queue users this library. So yes, all the system created output queues are created in this library, and all these pool files which are waiting for their turn to be printed are stored in the output queue, or are goes to the output queue, same as a job goes to the job queue for their turn to be processed. So spool files basically sites in the output queue waiting for their turn to be printed by the printer, which is configured or attached to the IBM machine. Device out queue, what it is. So basically out queue can be created by the system or can be created by the user. So when it is created by a system, it is called as device out queue. So when it's created, so when we attach or when we actually configure a printer to the IBM machine, then system by default creates an out queue and attach it to the printer, and that out queue name is same as the printer name. So that's called as the device out queue. Now let's move on to the second point, that is create output queue. So we can create our own out queue using the command create out queue. So here we can give, let's say, out queue 3 in library this sequential star 34. Let's press enter. So OUTQ3 is created in this library WRKOUTQ. So this output queue is created using the command create OUTQ. So next thing would be change OUTQ. So this command is basically to change the output queue parameters, which are basically provided the time of create output queue. So you can change the out queue 3 parameters. So you can change all these values. Take F10, this will show another other values, optional values. So you can change any value from here. Now next thing would be delete out queue. Take F4, out queue 3 easy plus 1. So this output queue is deleted successfully. If you take, or if you do work object out Q3, you'll see there are no objects anymore. Let's create it again so that we can show next things. So next command is work without Q, output Q, that is work out Q. So if I just type work out Q and press enter, it will show me all the list of the output queues. From there I can access the status of these output queues. If I want to access any particular out queue, let's say which we created, so you can see there are no spool files to this out queue right now. The status is released. This is available in this library, the class 1 out queue. Now let's take an example where I'm working with the status information for a specific output queue, QPRINT. So I'll be using the work out queue command, and we'll the status information of the QPRINT. So this output queue available in QGPL library, and these are the spool files which are there in the output queue. So you can see all these spool files are there, having a name, this, user data, this, status, this, number of pages, number of copies, form type is standard, priority. So all these things you can have. Just open any. So you cannot open them just because they are in ready state. So once they are printed, that then only you can access them. So it is not printed yet, so that's why you cannot display them. So that's what I want to show you, that that these reports or these two files are there in that OUTQ. So you got to know all these things from basic introduction of the output queue, how you will be using this. So that's all in this video. Thank you and have